Hi students, in today's session I'm going to teach you an excellent trick to draw and find total possible number of isomers for alkanes. First I'll teach you how to draw, then finding total number of isomers. At the end of this session I'm going to reveal you the trick to find total possible isomers. Thanks for giving a lot of likes and comments to my videos. It gives a boost up to do more concepts in easier way in the form of your favorite tricks. Let's start the concept first. Let me teach you how to draw. First, one carbon containing alkene is methane, which consists of one carbon. Write one carbon. Carbon valency is 4. So what you have to do is just put 4 bonds and place 4 hydrogens here. Next one is ethane. Ethane consists of 2 carbons. So write 2 carbons. Carbon valency is 4. Already one bond is there. Total it should consist of 4 bonds. One bond is there. So how many bonds you have to place? 4 minus 1 is 3. So you have to place 3 bonds. Here also one bond is there. So you have to place 3 bonds. In the place of bond, just you put here one hydrogen. Propane. It consists of, prop is a root word which consists of 3 carbons. Just write 3 carbons. In the same way, what is the carbon valency, students? 4. So one bond is there. How many you have to place? 3. 2 is there. How many you have to place? 2. One bond is there. How many bonds you have to place? 3 bonds. In the place here, what you should write? Take hydrogens here. These are the structures for methane, ethane, propane. You can't change the methane structure. Always it is carbon with 4 hydrogens. Ethane also same. If you change here and here, again we get the same structure. So for methane, ethane and even for propane also, they consist of these structures only. There are no other isomers for these methane, ethane and propane. What are isomers? 2 compounds which are having same molecular formula, but they should have different structures in case of structural isomers. But for these 3, there is no other possible structures. So there is no isomers. No isomers. Let us see for butane. Butane. How many carbons, students? How many carbons in this case of butane? 4 carbons. Write 4 carbons in the same way and place hydrogens. But every time writing like this, it consumes a lot of time. So I'll teach you another way, easy way to write. These formulas are called as structural formulas. Let us see the condensed formula. Carbon, how many hydrogens are there? 4 hydrogens. This is the condensed formula. And for this carbon with 3 hydrogens and put a bond, again carbon with 3 hydrogens. This is also condensed formula. And you can write bond or without bond also you can write. A carbon with 3 hydrogens, again carbon with 2 hydrogens, next carbon with 3 hydrogens. This is the condensed formula. Right. To save more time, let us see the bond line formula. Bond line formula means we have to represent this in the form of lines. Bonds we are going to represent in the form of line. Yes, first only one carbon, just put a dot. 2 carbons are there, right? Just put 2 dots and join this. This is ethane. What is ethane? Here one carbon is there, here one carbon is there. Between these two, only one bond is there. Total should be 4 bonds. Here one bond is there means how many bonds are left? 3. Total 4 bonds. Here only one bond you are seeing. How many bonds left? 3. It means that this carbon is having 3 hydrogens. And this carbon is also having 3 hydrogens. Because here one bond, here 3. Total 4 bonds. Got it? And coming to the propane. How many carbons? 3. 1, 2, 3. Just put 3 dots and join like this. Got it? Carbon. carbon, only one bond is there. Total 4, 1 is there means how many left? 3. Those 3 are there here. You have to imagine. And here 2 bonds is there to this carbon, middle carbon. So how many hydrogens it is having? Total 4. 2 are there, 2 is left. Now, coming to the butane. Total 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. Just put 4 dots and join this. 1 isomer. And next, what you do is total 4, right? Just take parent chain less than 1 carbon. Means take with 3 carbons. Total it should be 4. But you are taking only 3 as a parent chain. So place that here. If you put at first or last carbon, it gives the same structure. So don't prefer first and last. Keep the bond in between. Total how many isomers are possible? 2. Coming to the pentane. Total 5 carbons. So put 5 dots. Just join this. 3, 4, 5. Next 4 dots you put. Next 3 dots. Just take, reduce 1 carbon and take as a parent chain. Now join these 4 dots. Total carbon should be 5 for pentane. But you are taking only 4 as a parent chain. That remaining one, take here. Clear? Next structure, if you place that bond here, we get the same. So with 4 carbons as a parent chain, only 1 isomer is possible. Next, with the 3 carbons as a parent chain, total carbons is 5, but we are taking only 3. So remaining 2, place it here, here and here. Because if you place here and here, it gives the same structure of this and this. That is the reason place the 2 on the middle carbon. Then we get the different isomer. Total isomers are 3. Next, to calculate for hexane. Let us see for hexane. To do in the same way, it takes a lot of time, just 2 minutes or 3 minutes it will take in your exam. To reduce your time and by saving your time, I'm going to teach you an excellent trick. Use this trick so that you can do fatafat in your exams. Trick is 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 1. Now let us find for 1 carbon alkane. N is number of carbons. Then 2 to the power of, substitute in this formula. 1 minus 4 plus 1. Then how much we get? 2 to the power of minus 3 plus 1. This is negative value. So neglect this term. Neglect it. So how many isomers are possible, students? Only 1 isomer is possible for 1 carbon. N is equal to 2. Then 2 to the power of 2. Just to substitute N value here. 2 to the power of 2 minus 4 plus 1. How much? 2 to the power of minus 2 plus 1. Neglect this term because it is negative value. Then how many isomers are possible? Only 1. N is equal to 3. 2 to the power of 3 minus 4 plus 1. Then we get 2 to the power of minus 1 plus 1. Again negative value we got. Neglect that. Total number of isomers are only 1. Next. N is equal to 4. Then 2 to the power of 4 minus 4 plus 1. Then it will be 2 to the power of 0 plus 1. Anything to the power of 0 is 1 plus 1. Total how many? 2 isomers for 4 carbon containing alkane. What is this? Butane. Butane consists of how many isomers? How many isomers are possible for butane, students? 2. Next, 5 carbons, 2 to the power of 5 minus 4 plus 1, that is 2 to the power of 1 plus 1. Then we get 3. Total 3 are possible. Hexane, N is equal to 6. Then 2 to the power of 6 minus 4 plus 1. How much? 2 to the power of 2 plus 1. That is 5. Total 5 isomers are possible. This trick is valid up to 7 carbons. Up to only 7 carbons. Let us see for 8 carbons. This trick is valid up to only 7 carbons. So up to 7 carbons. What is the formula, students? 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 1. This is very, very easy trick. You may feel that these numbers I can remember and I can write in exam. Otherwise, I'll draw the structures and I'll find it. But in examination hall, if you know these tricks, you can solve very easily. Coming to the 8. 8 isomer. For 8 carbon containing alkane, the trick is to the power of n minus 4. Here 1, right? Here 2 for this. 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 2. For this, 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 3. Just solve this. See here, 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 2. For which compound? 8 carbon containing. Substitute here, 2 to the power of 8 minus 4 plus 2. How much, students? 2 to the power of 4 plus 2. So 2 to the power of 4. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, 16 plus 2 is 18. How many isomers are possible for 8 carbon alkane? That is octane, 18. Clear? And coming to the 9 carbon, it's very good trick. You can remember easily and you can solve these questions. 2 to the power of 9 minus 4 plus 3. Then how much? 2 to the power of 5 plus 3. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 16, 32, 32 plus 3, 35. Coming to this 10 carbon compound, formula is 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 1 you are taking, right? To this, n minus 4 plus 1, to this, add the total number of carbons plus n value you have to take. Suppose 2 to the power of 10 minus 4 plus 1 plus how many carbons? 10. Then you will get 2 to the power of 6 plus 1 plus 10. Total you get how many? 75. Suppose if you feel this formula is a tough formula, I am going to give you still more easiest method, that just add this total number of isomers. These all if you add, we get 75. Easy. Just see the summary. 1 to 7 carbons formula is 2 to the power of n minus 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 1. 8 carbon, 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 2. Next one is 2 to the power of n minus 4 plus 3. This is up to 7, 8 and 9. For 10, the sum of all the isomers is total 75. That's it. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. I forgot to give you the test yourself question. See here. Find the total possible number of isomers for heptane. What you have to do is just you have to draw the total number of isomers. By using this method what I taught you, just you have to draw the total isomers like this. Just you practice it. And after that, by using the trick, comment me your answer. I am going to give you the solution to this question in the description box.